Hello, my name is Scott Bryson, and I'm an applications engineer in Texas Instruments' position sensing product line. This video will discuss the various sources of error that may arise when calculating angular position using a rotating magnet, and how mechanical errors may be addressed through device configuration and calibration. As a quick review, using Hall effect sensors to measure absolute angle can be accomplished either by placing two one-dimensional sensors 90 degrees out of phase from each other, or by using a single 3D sensor to detect any two vector components which are naturally 90 degrees out of phase. This function is particularly useful in motor-driven applications and user control interfaces such as industrial robotics, electronic automotive steering, and dial controls, such as digital thermostat. 3D sensors offer great mechanical flexibility as they can be placed anywhere near the rotating magnet where sufficient magnetic flux density is present. Some common examples are on axis, where filled components are near ideal, in plane, and out of plane, which is also referred to as off axis. Amplitude mismatch is a very common error source. It may be the result of sensor placement about the magnet or may be caused by sensitivity mismatch. Sometimes, the magnitude of this mismatch can be quite large, and this will contribute to overall angle errors. Consider the angle error resulting from calculating the arctangent using Bx and By, which are not equal in amplitude. Regardless of the source of mismatch, when assigning inputs with unequal amplitudes to the arctangent function, the end result is effectively using an elliptical input to describe a circular motion. Observing this example rotation, the ellipse will both lead and lag the circle over the course of one full rotation. The angle error is zero at each 90 degree interval, but can be quite large in between. Amplitude correction, which is a feature of devices such as tmag 5170 or tmag 5273, allows the users to correct for this imbalance easily. Another helpful feature of these devices is offset correction. When a fixed offset is present, either from the device or system, an additional angle error will occur. For instance, here the two magnetic field components have an identical amplitude, but the offsets are present on both channels. The resulting angle error is sinusoidal in nature with a peak value, which is significant. Taking care to correct for both offset and amplitude differences, whether caused by the magnet or signal chain errors in the sensor, will greatly improve overall angle accuracy. This, however, only addresses errors which are easily managed by and typical to the sensor. A number of additional system-level error sources should also be considered in this application, namely magnet tilt or wobble, magnet centering, sensor alignment caused by tilt or offset of the sensor, and measurement noise. Magnet tilt occurs when the magnet body is not aligned orthogonally to the rotating shaft. In this case, the magnet will appear to wobble as it rotates. For small degrees of wobble, a 3D sensor placed on axis might not experience much error as a result. However, a sensor at a similar proximity placed in plane will observe a more significant error, even after correcting for amplitude differences typical to this orientation. Magnet centering can be described by a physical offset between the axis of rotation and the magnet center. When this kind of mechanical offset occurs, the result is that the proximity to the sensor or the alignment to the magnet will vary during one full rotation. Similar to the tilt error before, this tends to have a low effect on the on-axis case. This is largely due to the fact that the range to the magnet is not changing, and the field is mostly parallel to the face of the magnet while this offset is small. For large-scale errors, we would anticipate a more significant impact, and this would likely indicate a failure of the greater system. In the in-plane scenario, the resulting error is again cyclical in nature, and the maximum error will depend on the severity of the misalignment. In addition to the possibility of the magnet exhibiting some tilt and offset, the sensor can similarly be misaligned. Tolerances in manufacturing, soldering, or product assembly could result in small rotation errors or offsets from the ideal alignment. Again, visiting the on-axis case, where each mechanical misalignment resulted with minimal angle error, it is interesting to observe that when combining all the previous error sources, that a more complex angle error emerges. This cyclical error that occurs even with small degrees of misalignment is large enough to limit the overall system accuracy. To resolve this, calibration will be needed. A first approach to minimize total error might be to implement a multi-point calibration routine. By rotating the magnet as closely as possible to known angle locations or by capturing the peak error locations, it is possible to apply linearization to the end result. For example, a four-point calibration might be accomplished by determining the peak error locations and making linear approximations to correct the error. The resulting post-calibration error shows a significant improvement. A calibration of this nature will improve with greater number of linearization points as the approximation begins to more closely fit the real error. Another method, which requires more effort and characterization, is to determine the cyclical error and then correct for it using harmonic reduction. The goal here is to determine the factors for each harmonic to use when adjusting the output angle. While this approach requires a more detailed calibration to reach peak performance, the final accuracy is greatly improved. Consider the following algorithm. While this calibration factor would vary from system to system, we can describe the error of the on-axis system using corrections based on a series of harmonics. Here, sigma represents a fixed angle offset. Alpha represents a scalar correction factor for each particular harmonic. I is the harmonic number starting at the fundamental. N is the total number of harmonics to correct. And delta is a phase correction factor for that harmonic. Supposing only an effort to correct the fundamental and second harmonic with the on-axis example here, the new resulting error is virtually eliminated. One last error source which is noteworthy is to consider the impact of signal-to-noise ratio on the measurement. In the case where the input referred noise is close to 140 microtesla RMS, the overall impact on the measurement of each input channel would be quite small when the input amplitude is 70 millitesla. However, by comparison, the resulting angle error in systems with only 5 millitesla input will observe a more pronounced uncertainty. Ideally, this can be addressed by placing the sensor closer to the magnet in order to achieve a greater input signal. Additionally, the effective noise can be reduced through averaging. While this feature is included in devices like tmag 5170 or tmag 5273, it should be used as a secondary solution. Averaging samples will increase output delay, which may limit the maximum allowable rotation speed of the end system. To learn more about angle sensing, please refer to the following resources: absolute angle measurements for rotational motion using Hall effect sensors, angle measurements with multi-axis linear Hall effect sensors, linear Hall effect sensor angle measurement theory, implementation, and calibration, and the tmag 5170 2D angle error calculator, which is available in the tools section of the product page. This concludes this video. Thank you for watching. For more information and videos on magnetic sensors, please visit ti.com/halleffect.